It's the world-famous Purple Helmets, ladies and gentlemen, on any shite Sunday. You've probably seen the film with Steve McQueen, who, on any Sunday, raced across the desert. These men are hand-picked and breast-fed. They line up now for another epic show. Oh, who's this chap? Yes, he's the apprentice. We work along the line now, and they're in total disguise for the Child Support Agency. It cannot be recognized for legal reasons. We take it from here, ladies and gentlemen. They line up at Unken Stadium in the wonderful Isle of Man. And here is our hero for today. He goes shopping on Saturday morning, hardly noticed in the crowd. He walks through his own town in Douglas, Isle of Man, with his pet horse. Is he a professional man, you ask? I should say that he is. Is he a banker? No. Well, possibly. Is he an accountant? No. He goes into Ann Summers for his weekly shop. He looks satisfied as he comes out. He has the horse. They look both ways for road safety reasons and disappear into the crowd. This man, on a Saturday, is a professional man. He fights with his horse in the lift. He talks to him nicely. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we ascend to new heights. He goes up in the world with his horse. But tomorrow is another day. He joins the violent world of naked piano playing. He wears the number one plate on his buttocks. As we travel through time with the Hohner piano, he strikes up a tune or two as he tickles the ivories. On any Sunday, maybe, but this man is in the violent world of the naked pianist, ladies and gentlemen. A professional man in his own right. Follows the show through each and every venue. Ooh, and he's taken short here. It happens to everyone. He goes to his fellow. What a relief, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, that was so, so good. He waves to the crowd in jubilation. What a transformation. He remounts the piano as only he can. Continues to tickle the ivories as he drives away. Aha, you say it was a joke. Quite possibly. He's seen now in Douglas Promenade and TT Week. He follows his violent career as the naked pianist. And the lads in the crowd try to cool him down. Gathers momentum as he reaches a crescendo at the end of the promenade. He has all the beer he can possibly use. What a man. On any Sunday. His horse, meanwhile, has been stabled. He's champing at the bit. He waits to leave his stable for the wonderful show at Unken Stadium in the Isle of Man at the TT races. And what's happened? The horse emerges from the stable. He mounts the long bike. They roar away into the crowd. With the awesome power of the Honda 90 on full throttle, they've stolen a motorcycle, ladies and gentlemen, as only they can. No nagging there on his return. He made a horse's ass of that. It's Heysham Docks now with our very own double-decker bus. A handsome beast in any colour except yellow. She arrives on the dock side, ready for yet another epic trip. A picnic has been packed. carefully at every seat for each and every one of them. He's not there. Stunt team. They all turn out now and get themselves in the mood for a thrilling show at Rawtenstall, near the ski slope at Rossendale. An epic journey on a 1963 bus. The lads have a few minutes to themselves to relieve. And here's the Gimp himself. I don't know where we found him, but one of our guys checks the urine content in the hedge and says it's all okay. So we set off again. We arrive at Garstang, and this guy is really enthused with Mui as he waves to him from the window of the bus. The Gimp has passed out by now, as you will see. He's had more than enough. Still asleep. Oh, he's woken him up. Do you know this man?
The steering wheel is set at an angle. It's pushed over at an angle to assist the driver when he pulls it round. Because despite the weight of the vehicle, it hasn't got power steering. It's a 1963 AEC. Region 5, one of the last AECs supplied to Douglas Corporation Transport.
And now we enter the town of Preston to pick up the biggest Gimp of all. We arrive at his little bungalow, and his next door neighbour is quite amused. He offers us a ladder, but we decline the invitation. I bet he never knew that he would get on such a famous film. And here's the Gimp himself. He comes out now. His bike is carefully prepared and laid in the garden. He's not allowed to go without his teddy bear. So his teddy bear is loaded carefully with him. He's the nearest man we have to Alexei Sale. And he's booked us all into a very nice hotel.
We call this hotel What We've Got.
Oh, hello, are you the manager?
Hello!
Mr. Fawlty. Mr. Farquhar. Mr. Fawlty, this is Mr. Collins. Mr. Farquhar.
Where are we?
Mr. Collins,
we'll see you later.
One can see the enthusiasm as they book into such a fine establishment. And we're up with the crow, or the rooster, as you call it in the country. We start the vintage bus, and the lads arrive in various states of undress to be greeted by an early morning fog. Oh, hang on, no, I think it's the smoke from the bus. As she makes her way towards Rossendale on full throttle. Ooh, and we've met another vintage bus and his baby. As we go round the roundabout now, our own bus puts out plenty of pollution for the Lancastrian people. It's going very, very well. And we wave to the driver as we go past. Now, which way do we go here?
Worth seeing, one scene.
Here we are now. We
arrive. All the way from the Isle of Man via the USA.
A rotund person gives us his greeting as we arrive. And we assemble the bikes on the green by the local cricket pitch. Curious last-minute preparations now. As they prepare for the show. There's a set list nailed to every bike. The lads wear dark glasses at this time of the day because of the beer from last night. The shopping bike is brought out of the bus. The assembled visitors make sure that they're ready for the thrilling spectacle that awaits them.
One complete lap. Hazel do. No. Hazel will do.
A final pep talk from Charlie.
Who's Hazel anyway?
And all is well.
Wait, just do.
Who's that? Is that you?
Yeah,
is that?
All right.
Hey. Yeah. 99. Yeah.
Right.
We get a move this bike.
Yeah, we've got
follow me for the changes.
It's so well organised, we even bring an apprentice along with us. We have our own traffic warden. They rev the machines now. And someone tries to talk sense to the crowd as they circle round on the local cricket pitch and attempt to rip it to pieces with the back wheel of the smoke bike. He does a burnout on grass, which is very, very difficult. The long bike swings into action at the beginning of the show, to the thrill of the crowd. Easy peasy, one might say. Perhaps not. And a roll of roofing felt is used for the rollover bike as she does a stupendous rollover at Rawton Stall in Lancashire. That's in England, you know. The boys are down, but not out. They lie down, they're jumped over in great style. What a wonderful show, you may say. Or not, as the case may be. And here's our old mum with the shopping. Silly old cow, you may say. And you're probably right. And here she comes now with the shopping. Woo! Mum, you've crashed into your boys. And here they go now. They proceed to knock the seven bells out of mum and kick her bottom. Because isn't that what mums are for? They help her back on her scooter, she picks up her glasses and rides away. Isn't that lovely? And now here's Bert Colley, all the way from the Isle of Man. Bert Colley is the famous Steve Colley's even more famous brother. He revs up now. And he leaps himself over the assembled crowd without so much as a motorcycle. The boys take their bow for a well-earned rest and a pint. And we'll get back to you later.
Will that be using a safety net?
Now here, this is a one-off appearance in that London Village, England, at the rear of Alexandra Palace. A surprised lineup, and an even more surprised stuntman flies through the air. Absolutely stupendous. They lie on top of him just to keep his ardour cool. Now, Methane Man turns out on the rocket bike. He has the methane cone. He has the cone in his bottom and a tin of beans in front of him. He's been trained on Pernod and duck eggs for a fortnight to increase his methane capacity. The speed of the bike is awesome as he fires down the straight. Don't let your children watch this, or they'll all want a cone in their bottom. In his many guises as the man in the street and the professional man you wondered about before, he returns to the violent world of entertainment with his nappy on. He is now Roller Skate Man. He works his way through the week with the most stupendous stunts with his Honda 90 on full throttle. He is now the Witch's Hat. He carries a bin bag just to pick up his rubbish as he goes past. Oh, his trousers seem to have slipped, but he still wears the number one plate. I can clearly see it marked on his bottom. He's now having a shower after a hard day's work. In fact, I think it's a golden shower. It is. It is the same man. It's that man in the street that did his shopping so innocuously at Jane Summers less than an hour ago. He's now Darth Vader. What an adaptable man he is, ladies and gentlemen. And now, to cap it all, he's the Pope. We had a Pope selection process earlier this year. He's still number one, but barely visible. He wears a hat that is appropriate for the job, and he is the new Pope of the Isle of Man. And now here we are in the tranquil waters. And the beautiful. Now, who's this? I think this looks like a pregnant lady. It is a pregnant lady, and a very good-looking one. She's crying, and she's shaking her fist. Ooh, it's the cat. The cat goes on holiday. Ooh, I think he's taken the underwater bike to France on his holidays. But even in his busy schedule, he still found time to wave goodbye to his pregnant girlfriend. He descends beneath the waves, and his periscope is barely visible. He's gone. He's out of sight. Oh, and two more birds are there to wave him goodbye. He now emerges. I think he's made it. I think he's made it across the channel. Let's see. He has the shark's fin on the top to scare away. And he has. It's France. He's in France. Toot toot. We know it's France because there's a Frenchman. He abandons the bicycle and strides ashore in France. This is the cat as only we know him, ladies and gentlemen. He comes out, he tucks his aqualung away. What an athlete. French music as well. What a beautiful place. He greets his friend. And he waves to the assembled crowd. And he's brought a fish. You may say. And, ooh, he divests his coat and waves hello to the French people. The cat as only we know him. He hugs Marcel. And he's called for the waiter. And here he comes now. And it must be France because he wears the beret, as only the French can. Ho, 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 you may say. Celebrity du monde, le casque violet. But wait, it's the police. The police roar to a halt. I can see the Bobby's helmet in the back of the van. He leaps out. And the chaps run away. I can't understand why, but they run away. And the policeman meters out some justice of his own. Enough of that, you may say. The cheeky devils. Well, our next vacation takes us to the Czech Republic. Things calm down a bit now, and they watch the motorcycling action. As you'll know from our previous video, that our holidays each year are taken at the 6 days Enduro, a wonderful, restful time. Now, what's happened to the truck? We draw straws to see who will drive the truck, and this year it's Basil Fawlty. He lashes his truck. His truck is broken down, and lo and behold, he's released his load of immigrants. He dumped his load by the side of the road, ladies and gentlemen, and here they come now. They run away from the truck so the police won't apprehend them. A toilet is waiting, but they refuse the offer. Oh, said Charlie. Now, what kind of illegal immigrants are they? They don't know where they are. Is it the Czech Republic? Look out, he's a motorcycle. They run for their lives. But wait. Police are on hand. The police have apprehended them. What seems to be the trouble, sir? I think the police have offered them a lift. Now, they're in a very interesting town with a very, very interesting clock. In fact, they've become clock watchers. Either that or they're just waiting for the day when they can go home. A very exciting place. Mr. Piss has turned up, and his son. More beer, you may say. And they tuck in. The gimp has come back to life. Ah, a little bit of umpire music as only we know how to enjoy it. Shot glasses are handed out. And drunk in the appropriate fashion. Or not, as the case may be. What a sample. Ooh, I think they're sharing a cigarette. Goodness knows what's in it. But our lads join in the entertainment as only they can. And they make friends with the locals. I don't know exactly what he said, but if I could lip read, he probably said something like, "That's enough, you Manx twat." Dave wears the beer goggles. Johnny brings the drink. Things are going swimmingly. Czechoslovakia as you've never seen it before. They dropped the Slovakia because it made too much mess, and it's now known as the Czech Republic. Ooh, yeah. The gimp takes a beer shampoo. Some of our lads discussed the previous night's entertainment, but our next guest is His Excellency, the Lieutenant Governor of the Isle of Man. Your Excellency, we are most honoured and privileged to have this interview with you today. We believe that you're now unemployed and you fancied a job as a purple helmet.
What can I say? I don't think the boys would ever accept me, Derry, to be perfectly honest. I'm far too old.
Well, let's just run your CV through here and see if you're acceptable first.
Right,
and then
okay.
We'll make our decision. We'll need a few days, of course. Mm-hmm. I'll have to run it past the committee, but
yeah.
We'll see what happens.
Right.
We just need to know a little bit of background about you. Air Marshal Ian McFadyen.
Mm-hmm.
On the way up to Air Marshal, were you Air Vice Marshal at all?
I was, yes.
You were. So now that you've moved on, who looks after the Vice?
Well, that would be a secret, wouldn't it? Yes.
The Vice was probably more in our line, actually, than the flying. But you've been in the Gulf War and you've come all the way to the Isle of Man. And what a transition, really, to be a purple helmet, if successful.
Of course. Now, that is presupposing that I'm successful, but it would be quite a transition, I have to say. But, you know, I've done formation teams before, so in that regard, I'm well qualified. I was number three in an aerobatic team, so least I've tried to be in close formation with somebody else.
Well, that certainly will stand you in good stead to join the lads. You might have to brush up a little bit on your thing, because we have very exacting standards.
Well,
in the
I do know that, Derry, and that worried me slightly, I must admit, but Royal Air Force standards are pretty high too, you know.
Yes, I believe so, but possibly not quite as high as our standards.
Right, yes.
But, so what was it in the first place that attracted you to the RAF? You know, when was it you first realised you were a bit of a flyboy?
Well, I think when I was about 12 years old. As a matter of fact, I had my appendix out about that stage, and I went to an RAF hospital, and I was put in a ward where people were having plastic surgery. Goodness knows why, but what the connection was particularly. But I was, and lots of young airmen there who were very keen on building model aeroplanes, and one of them gave me one.
I just wondered if Ian was your real name. It's not Biggles or Ginger or anything like that.
No, I never had anything fancy like that. No, I was just a humble airman.
Most of the chaps had a bit of a handle to their name. Biffo, maybe, no?
No, I didn't have any special name, no.
So there's no skeletons in the cupboard?
I don't think so. Well, if there are, they're jolly well staying there, I'll tell you.
We maybe bring them to light if you're successful.
Of course, no. Well,
of course. Yes. So you like to get the old flaps moving and soaring to new heights of pleasure with the old joystick between your legs.
Yeah, of course.
And the RAF type. And I think you have possibilities. I think you probably have. But we'll go on. We'll just see how far we can take this. Charismatic, charming, intelligent. God. But enough about the helmets. I'll probably find a position for you because you'd probably, I will go as far as to say that initial impressions are good.
Mm-hmm.
You've interviewed well. I'd have to say to you that you probably have to put a bit of weight on because we all have to double up in our roles.
Right.
And you may be called on from time to time to step
in on
the piano.
I'm not sure my wife will allow that, I have to say. Mm. No, that's going to be difficult, I think, yes.
You find the piano a problem.
I don't think my bum's up to the piano, I have to say.
Well, there's one or two hiccups here. The formation flying certainly stands you in good stead.
I've done rolls and loops and things like that, you know, so that
the rollovers.
That wouldn't be a problem, no, that's right, yeah.
We could probably stand in for rollover man from time to time.
Well, I think we should have two, actually, Derry, one side by side, you see, and do it together, yes.
And play the old fly past as
that's right,
as
we could do the opposition manoeuvres, you see, that'd be very good, yes, yeah.
That'd be splendid.
Well, Derry, thank you for that. I think it's very unlikely I'll ever make the team, I have to say, because of your very demanding standards. But it would be nice to be considered, I have to say.
They are high standards. And don't worry about being unemployed. I want to stress that because you may be back here very soon.
Well,
and we'll find you a little place to live and that sort of thing.
That'd be nice.
Take
up
a new career.
If you're paying for it, Derry, I'll certainly come. Yes.
You could certainly take up a new career with the Purple Helmets. Ian McFadden, thank you very much.
Derry, thank you very much.
Truly a wonderful ambassador for the Isle of Man. And he deserved a wonderful send off. And that's exactly what we tried to give him when we escorted him to the boat with our motorcade. And now we can add to our repertoire that we do royal send-offs. An absolute gentleman and his lovely lady. And now it's back to action at the Onken Stadium. The cat let the dog see the rabbit, ladies and gentlemen, as the hounds chase after the hare. They chase after the catman round Onken Stadium at speeds approaching 100 miles an hour. The kids are absolutely delighted. They hope the pussy will get away, but the lads are in hot pursuit. As the pussy spreads his legs, he's back on the footrests. He's round the corner, breakneck speed. Will they catch him? They've given up. He's got a brand new cat suit this year. And now the holiday of a lifetime in Brazil. The ISDE for 2003 was in Brazil, of all places. The heat was absolutely incredible. But the boys would not take the coats off until the last minute. They race across the dunes in breakneck style through the puddles with true purple helmet action. They're back in the bogs again. Spend a lot of their time with bog humour. You can see the awesome power of the cat bike. And I'll say it at the risk of repeating myself, happiness is a wet pussy. On the red-hot sand in Brazil, the boys give the salute to the cameraman as they leave each morning for a hard day's tracking. The beautiful noise of the Honda four-stroke engine. Some very smart machines here, very well turned out. It's one footrest, it's the salute to the crowd. What you would expect from a Purple Helmet's holiday. The flag is being flown, albeit the wrong flag, and a race is in progress. With the mighty Purple Helmets, they launch themselves into the motocross test. Full throttle. Head down, bowels open. Oh, the cat's down. The cameraman swerves to avoid him, narrowly misses an onlooker. The piano man takes part. With his Irish background, he's a natural. He spurs his mount on to greater things in the style of an Irish jockey. He spurs his bike over the finishing line to a huge cheer. And now day-to-day action in the Brazilian holiday. Very, very nice too. Look, boys and girls. They power along the beach now in Brazil. And two of the lads got back early. They've taken their coats off and are sunbathing. Two more come along and try to achieve the same tan. But first, a cooling off period. Fantastic. And there he is. He's back on show. It's our very own piano man. He pops up everywhere. The refreshment of it is wonderful. On a hot day. Woo! Don't drown those puppies.
Much to the girls' amusement, Finn powers himself across the beach. He goes for a power swim. Very, very nice, he said. Like a little herd of elephants up the beach. I don't know what they're hanging on to there. The one in front hangs on to the one behind. I think they're starting to flag now in the Brazilian heat. How much is a Brazilian, President Bush asked.
Jim, I'm worried, really worried.
No problem. Don't let
it. Now, we move into a new realm. It's Galvanized Man. He has a sheet of galvanized, jauntily posed at an angle of 30 degrees. Oh, and he's dropped his galvanized. He's off on the ground. The lads take a welcome break now. They lounge about on the armchairs and the sofa action. The cat sits on the sofa. We attempt to clean up our act, as we've been asked to do on many occasions. Jim tests the ground, a bit dirty, he says, so he continues with the Hoover. We cleaned up Onken Stadium. In front of the assembled crowd, the Hoover is used for the first time. The chair has broken down. Oh, wheelie, you may say. And now it's Skid Marks, our ski instructor. He skis down the main straight, and now he's on Douglas Promenade. He shouts to the crowd. He returns the abuse they offer him. He's down the promenade in TT week at the wonderful Isle of Man TT races, ladies and gentlemen, one-handed on the titanium skis. What a slider, you may say. He's down Cock 6 or Cock 7.
Okay, we're now at Hotel La Shit. And we're just going to take a look around the room to see if it's good quality accommodation. I think they should be empty.
Hello, welcome to our beautiful apartment block. If you come in here, you can look at this beautiful shower. Excuse me.
This is the Slovakian experience.
Here that's been left by the previous occupants. There appears to be some peanuts, a banana skin, a drinks carton, and used condom. And on the top shelf, there appears to be some human scat. Which is beautiful, really. The cupboards are really very functional, very easy access, designed for easy access. You just take the cupboard off, front off, and you can get in without even needing to slide out the apartment for unit. Which is super.
What's a fucking piece of shit, man.
There seems to be some problem with this bed. It comes...
These beds have actually got storage. Oh, we were told.
Solid lift up storage.
This is the wardrobe.
And you can actually store your own sex gear.
It's the time now, is 8 o'clock. Not very happy. This is the bloody in the morning. This hotel is not good. And also, there's some very strange people walking around in this place.
Just the thing after a night's hangover, a good dose of beer, and our own band in tribute to the brass band. Very musical. And now, our man, as famous as he is, he decides to lose weight, so the boys buy him a sauna suit. They try it on to see if it'll fit, and the sauna suit appears to fit, but they want to see if they can trap the sweat inside by testing the waterproof from the outside. A gallon of beer is launched over him. And he nods in approval. Yes. So his bike is now decontaminated. It's thrown in the sheep dip. Well, that's what we call it. but it was actually a swimming pool for the hotel. Hardly deep enough to swim in, you may say, but not for our intrepid piano man. He wears his sauna suit to great effect as he mounts the bike. The lads straighten it out, and he decides to decontaminate himself and join Weight Watchers. Here he goes now. He rides at breakneck speed through the water. And does a gentle donut on the other side. I think he will attempt the wall of death in a minute. Let's see what he performs like. Oh, and another gentle donut on the other side. Now a demonstration from the main man himself. That's how you do it. He collapses in the water with the sheer pressure of beer inside his body. He helps Sauna Man to the top. But his bike is still not cleansed, so they launch it back in again. And now they test his suit to destruction by filling it with beer from the inside and attempting to drink it. Truly a star, but the police may have other things to say. And here they come now. What do you think, Mr. Polizia? He's not a happy man. So Mr. Polizia and his mate have arrested Louis. I don't know why. Mr. Great Britain runs behind. And now, a trayful of ale for a local to show our generosity. Whoops! We spilt the whole damn lot over him. But to show no hard feelings, he helps him retrieve his bike. The locals really are very friendly in Slovakia. And Dan attempts to fix a puncture, closely watched by Mr. Piss. Mr. Piss insists on being part of the action, so he attempts to show Dan, who mops his brow at the same time, he attempts to show Dan how to fix the puncture. And between the two of them, with many attempts later, an hour passes by, and it's on, it's off. It's on, it's off. Frantic action. Where would Dan be without Mr. Piss? The wheel's back in the bike, and
that's how you do it.
Back in the Isle of Man now for the TT races for 2005. They assemble on the quayside at the Clarendon Hotel, much to the delight of the locals, and decide to go in for a pint. The floor looks a bit grubby in there. I wonder if they'll polish it up a bit. One or two of them do try to clean the place up. He polishes some of the black muck off the floor on full throttle. On the awesome Honda 90. He powers it round in the public bar. And then he goes for it. He's hit the wall. An onlooker, I think he's a German in a yellow suit, pats him on the back. And now we're back to Donut Man. Silver Surfer himself. A cool man, no hands on the handlebars, a feet up donut. This bike has been perfected over many seasons. Totally out of control. He shows his many facets. He's off. He's a bit puddled, I think, that day. He gives the bike power. He waves to the crowd. He's blown a gasket, but that's all part of his trademark. He rides entirely by smell. And he waves to the crowd, absolutely confident. Back at Onken Stadium now. A pyramid is formed in fine style on the blow of the whistle. Precision as you've never seen it before. As only the purple helmets can, two huge man-made erections called pyramids crash into one another. The lads are a little hungry and a pizza arrives. The fire brigade are on hand to squirt any little squirt who gives them cheek. Sparks fly from the ladder. The wheelie bin race, fantastic action at Onken Stadium. There's the cat in full flight in total shite, the bin without the bottom in it. Number four, Cornell, brings up the second place. The clown's pocket number seven comes into view. It's just like the Grand National. Cat keeps his head down now. He comes round the corner on full throttle. The four-man Bob comes round the corner. Oh, now you mustn't lose your head at this sort of sport. The assembled crowd think it's wonderful. Well, we hope they do. As graceful as Swan Lake itself. Formation flying with the wonderful purple helmets. Over the top we go, underneath we go. The bear waves hello to the crowd. 1 foot. Hello. The chaps are off now. There's something wrong with the bike, I think. They're going to study it. Ooh, wait a minute. The bike's away on its own. There's something wrong here. Hang on, I think there's someone still inside there pulling the strings. Just as we thought. Here he comes now. Out. Out. That'll teach that blighter a lesson. He takes a turn. I think the bike's turned nasty. This is an ugly-looking piece of kit, ladies and gentlemen. They always turn nasty on them. This is almost magic. Or could it be remote control? I think it is. It's remote control. I think the man has it in control. Ooh, possibly not anymore. And now it's the cannonball, the human cannonball. He's signed into the cannon. And without a thought for his own safety, he is fired across the stadium at speeds approaching 100 miles an hour.
You weren't supposed to see that.
And it's a jousting competition now. From the Northern Jousters, Sir Brownrod. On his trusty steed, as in days of old, when knights were bold and toilets weren't invented, they dropped their load in the middle of the road and walked away contented. The bike is mortally wounded and down she goes. She's on the ground. The little bit of bad language in the bucket, we'll blot that out later. All hell breaks loose now. Let him live. Let him live, you cry.
can.
We're talking here with a very famous man, well known in the Isle of Man, because they've even named a walk after you. They call it the Parish Walk. I don't know if you're aware of that, Steve. But
I wasn't actually. No, I'm very honoured to hear that. Yeah, and there's one or two areas I think they're called parishes as well.
They
around
do.
Here.
They
yeah.
do. I think yeah. they're called after you as well.
Yeah.
I'm not too sure on that, but well, looking back on things, you know, you're very well known in the Isle of Man through your road racing exploits and things, and obviously you're a bit of a legend as a truck racer and that sort of thing. But you're probably better known for your recent divorce. And, you know, I mean, I believe you were attracted to the idea of the purple helmet some time ago. And you're no stranger, really, to the Bobby's helmet, are you? Because, I mean, I'm not embarrassing you when I say that your wife's buggered off with a policeman. Do you mind talking about that?
No. Obviously, it's very upsetting for me after a long, long period together. They say that beauty's skin deep, so I think my wife must have been inside out, actually. But yes, you're right, my wife went off with a policeman recently, and I was chased by one just a fortnight ago, and when I didn't stop after about 6 miles, he was quite mad about it all, and I said, well, I was a bit concerned that you'd bring my wife back, and he actually didn't find that at all funny. But and of course I do have a policeman's hat, which brings me into that. I like to wear my policeman's hat when in traffic, and all the women on the phone, they chuck their phone on the floor because they think they're about to get booked. But it's just one of the silly things that one does to pass the time of day.
Yeah, good dodge, good dodge. We must remember that. You know,
so you'll have to get one.
Well, we liked this guy, and we decided to help him. So the next time we saw a policeman, we laid him down in front of the bikes and decided to take our own revenge for Steve Parish. We thought he'd had a rough deal with the Bobby's helmet, so we decided to ride over him. Is that him, you say? The finger has been pointed. Is he the Bobby's helmet that buggered off with Steve's wife? We'll soon find out. He didn't bat an eyelid. I think it is him. We're back on holiday now. They do some adjustments. We've got the set list in front of us. He gets the mice out of his pocket.
Yeah, what am I doing on the spanners? I'm a professional. Jeez, it's up to you.
The stuff been in that pocket since 1995.
Yeah, 5 years that way. 97, never been worn. Soiled, mind you.
What a load of junk in your pocket. This is at the Great Edinburgh Motorcycle Show some years ago. They struggle for pole position. Always cold in Scotland. Another mind-blowing show. Oh, that hurt, I think. Not many of those in a pound, you may say, as he walks across the seats of the moving Hondas. He does it. There's a gimp as he goes along on the back wheel. Another one who's gathered a bit of muck from his back wheel. Beautifully prepared machine here. The front wheel's dropped out. I think the wheel's keeping pace with him here. He's had enough of that. It's the long bike. And Toilet Man. He looked a bit flushed to me. And now they ride over a pile of mulch. Thank you very much, you may say. Or not, you weren't that stupid, I don't know, you may do. Warm up for the next show by riding over the gardener's mulch. I'm sure he's very pleased about this. He's probably spent quite a while tidying it all up, and now they're spreading it all around Edinburgh. But the action gets better. As you can see, bikes are cast away willy-nilly. A local girl turns out to have a look. Watches the gimps ride over the mulch. And
and one of them attempts to chatter up the dirty beast. I think that hurt a bit. We may get to see that later. A plank is placed in strategic position for more speed. It knows no barriers, ladies and gentlemen. That was a riderless machine, fired into space by its hapless owner. They seem to be totally out of control here. But this is Edinburgh. He laid down his bike. In the name of the Purple Helmets. A wonderful organization that knows no bounds. They try faster and faster until eventually they can't stop at all. There's the injury sustained from a jump over the mulch. Thank you very much, sir. Not much sympathy there, boy.
One for the bin.
Well, we've been repeatedly asked to clean up our act, and here we are going through the car wash at Ramsey in the Isle of Man and TT Week in 2002. He's cleaned the helmet on the way through. Ready for action. A car wash as you've never seen it. The boys are in disguise now. They really don't want to be recognised. It's the year of the foot and mouth, so they cleanse the bikes through the foam and the foot bath. They attempt to do a wheelie for the whole distance of the stadium at Onchan and the Isle of Man. It's the Great Chainsaw Massacre now. And the legs are cut clean off the riders by two chainsaws. And different coloured balloons are attached so that they know their own leg. Purely for identification purposes. Hang on, I don't think that... Oh, thank you, he said. That's not your leg, sir. Somebody's been pulling his leg. It's the long bike on the way to the pub. This is quite a stretching experience. Who's this little guy? He's nipped in underneath. He's going for the pasties. Now the side show that you've all waited for. Cream cakes are loaded into the machine and fired at the ducks. Ducks are knocked down one by one in a ceremonial fashion. Great accuracy is achieved with our special pie flinger. And down goes the cat. He's been splattered with a cream cake. It's the bar dive, as ever. What a wonderful crowd of people, ladies and gentlemen. The world famous Purple Helmets. And now it's the old sheep's goal. Bolted on the front mudguard of the bike. The boys take a nap. I suspect that there's some alcohol involved here somewhere. Yes, I was right.
And this is my friend Al Quentos.
Get up! Yes, but, sorry, that's,
it's
very difficult here for this interview, but we'll try our best to give you all the information you need.
We like
In Poland, we like kielbasa with two Oh, training again, sorry. We love men.
It's back on the field now, with flat-out action in the world-famous purple helmets. You guessed it, at speeds approaching 100 miles an hour. The action is ongoing. The cat has had another one of his lives there. How many lives has he got, I wonder? Ooh, I think that hurt. Is this Polish mud or Manx mud? You may well ask. Mud is mud, you say. Ooh. He made a bollocks of that, ladies and gentlemen. We're back in the Isle of Man at the Railway Pub in Union Mills, our headquarters, for the wonderful TT Week ride-through of the Railway Pub. Our erstwhile landlord, meanwhile, will be sitting at the piano waiting for us. And here he is. He gives us a tune on the old Joanna to give Piano Man a rest. Come out of the pub now and decide to ride the rest of the distance. The long track races. On any Sunday, eat your heart out. The number one plate in the Isle of Man is not easily achieved. Back to Onchan now and our old mum. More shopping, more food for the boys. They've got big appetites, these lads. He screams a bit, shows a bit of leg and rides right over the boys. We love our old mum. Looks like a nice lot of shopping there for the chaps. Mmm. Yummy, scrummy.
Shopping basket, throw him behind.
Straight back onto scissors, so look who's on the scissors on the bike.
Scissors! This is a clerical do by the look of it.
Straight back in for that then, no break.
I think this is where we choose the new Pope. The cardinals arrive, they swing the incense as they go. Total mayhem. A bit like the selection of the Pope himself, really. And they take off now. They're after the altar boy. The Cardinals chase the altar boy at speeds approaching 100 miles an hour. Will they catch the little altar boy? Now this is a new invention. This is what we call the bike loader. We thought it would speed our act if we could load the bike at speed. The passenger runs along, bounces on the trampoline and completely misses the bike. A little more practice there, I think. Total mayhem. It's the wheelie bin race now. Fast and furious action through the water. Starring the cat. Closely followed by the Laxey four men, Bob, and only three men in it. Don't try this at home, kids, because it's very dangerous. Well, we're coming to the end now, and we do hope you enjoyed this offering of On Any Shite Sunday. And if not, tough.